Yes, I want to do video.
Video.
Yes. Okay. Yes, yes, you can. Yes. Okay. Okay. It's on now.
Alright, so good morning everybody. Today we'll be looking at the criminal justice system in Nigeria. The criminal justice system in Nigeria. Talking about the criminal justice system in Nigeria, the past weeks we've examined the criminal justice system in different jurisdictions like Pakistan, like India, like China, like Italy, like Indonesia, like Kazakhstan, like Mongolia, and now we're looking at the criminal justice system in Nigeria. Introduction. Nigerian society is made up of people with diverse cultures and ways of life. The people relate to one another in the course of their daily existence. In this process of relationship with each other, some people intentionally, deliberately, or inadvertently often step on the toes of others. A redress has been put in place in order to check the excesses of the defaulting persons if peace and order are to be maintained. Now, based on this premise that the government has put in place criminal law which regulates the certain conduct of people towards others. So, like this well stated here, because of human relationship, because of human relations that are amongst themselves, there could be issues, there could be issues of misunderstandings or deliberate attempts to hurt another person, defraud another person, or take advantage of another person. So in order to checkmate all these excesses, to make sure that human existence is not about the strong gets it all over the weak, and it's not about whoever has the more privilege or chance or energy or sweep can be able to oppress another person. The state tries to introduce balance to check the excesses of people. This negotiated, this bettered the necessity of bringing about criminal law. Now, when we're looking at criminal law, it regulates some certain, conduct of people towards others. You can see the Nigerian population. Nigeria is about 150 million. This is just a typical market in Lagos, Nigeria. We have this crowd of people. But Nigeria is really, really big. Now, sources of Nigerian criminal law. The major source of Nigerian criminal law is the English common law received from England. However, we talk about English common law received from England, talking about the statutes from the parliament and the decided cases from the judges. However, what appears to be governance of Nigerian criminal law are various statutory amendments such as our constitution, the Act of National Assembly, government councils, people who government council, state council, whatever government council at any level. They have subsidiary legislations of government departments. These are the things that make up our criminal law system. Now, it may also include decrees and edicts of criminal matters promulgated during the military regime. So, there were times you used to have a military regime, then the military government used to rule by decrees and edicts. Decrees of federal military government, edicts by the state's military government. So, these form the sources of Nigerian criminal law as we know it today. Now, there are both statutes which we have mentioned may be grouped into three distinct categories. The first category are the many statutes made by the federal, state, and local government councils in Nigeria, which take care of various technical or specific offences, whose purpose is to regulate the conduct of the people through sanctions or punishments contained in such offences. So, number one is the statute. Now, the second category of criminal statutes are the Criminal Code Acts. And that's Cap 77, the Constitution of Nigeria 2004, and the Penal Code Law of 1959. The Criminal Code Act covers the southern part of Nigeria, whereas the Penal Code applies in northern states of Nigeria. You have to understand that Nigeria is divided into the northern part of Nigeria and southern part of Nigeria. In within both, we have six geopolitical zones in Nigeria. The northern part of Nigeria is largely dominated by Muslims, and that's where you have the Sharia law in effect. So, in effect. So, what happens is that influenced by the culture and the customs of the people, whereas the criminal code is as well influenced by the culture and the customs of the people. So the reason why we have different acts of legislation governing different regions is not because crime is different in those regions, but because of the peculiarity of each of the regions. And the third is judicial precedent. If an invest in court decisions interpreted to give precision to some difficult legislative provisions, and also set a pattern for future decisions in their cases. So the third is one's judicial precedent. Like I said earlier, Professor Wendell Holmes was asked, what is law? And he said, law is the prophecies of what the courts will do, and nothing more pretentious is what he means by law. In other words, this pattern taken by judges in previous cases determine what future cases could be like. So these are things that actually influence our criminal law system in Nigeria. Now, what's the crime in Nigeria? Among many other definitions, the legislative and juristic approach in defining what a crime is in Nigerian society is kind of similar. Now, the Nigerian Criminal Code defines an offense, that's a crime, as an act or omission which renders the person doing the act or making the omission liable to punishment under the code or under any order in the council, ordinance, or laws or statutes. So, the Criminal Code tries to define act as an act, but you know that crimes are not just acts, they are as well omissions. So if you refrain from doing something you're meant to do, it could be a crime. So it's either an act or an omission which renders the person doing that act or making that omission liable to punishment. But the punishment must be what is defined under the code. In other words, what is not defined under the code, it cannot be held liable to as a punishment for it. So if, for instance, you commit murder and it's not defined under the code as murder, you can't be held liable to have committed murder. And if, for instance, you commit murder on the 1st of January 2016 and they make a law on the 2nd of January 2016 against murder, nobody can try you with that feature law, because at the time you committed that murder, it was not defined under the code. So that's how the code defines law. So there must be an action or an omission which the person doing it is liable to punishment, and the punishment is provided for under the code or any other laws like the orders of from the council, ordinance, or laws or state or statutes. However, the juristic approach to this, one of the many laws we have in Nigeria, defined crime as those breaches of law resulting in special accusatorial procedure controlled by the state and liable to sanction over and over its human costs. So they try to see a crime as something beyond civil wrongs. Not in civil wrongs, it could be compensation, it could be damages, it could be costs. But when it comes to crime, it's over and above that. People are liable to punishment and sanctions from the state. You know, it tries to introduce another factor to it, that this is the state that is prosecuting for crime, not a private individual now. It is the state that is prosecuting for crime. Ordinarily, when there are issues of criminal proceedings, it's the Attorney General of the state or the federation that is prosecuting. However, in special cases, private individuals can get the fiat of the Attorney General to prosecute on his or her behalf. But the norm, the pattern is that the Attorney General prosecutes on behalf of the state for the people working in his team. So it's always the state against the accused person. Now, what are the elements of the crime? You can see him giving the person a blow. Now, this is the actus reus, and this is the mens rea. Now, there must be deliberate attempt to commit a crime. There must be an event. By an event in this sense, I mean there must be a meeting of the mind and action in committing a crime. Nobody can independently call a crime a single act divorced of the other part. So there must be an actus reus, the actual act, and a mens rea, the evil intention. Two of them must be present in a crime in most cases. However, there could be exceptions to this. So he says, no one can be held guilty of a crime that is not defined by the law. The elements of the crime are contained in that particular offense, depending on how the offense the institution was present to secure a conviction. So these are the physical elements, which is the accessory, which is the actual punch, the mental element, which is the necessary, the intention. So you can see this is a crime. So it's when this evil thoughts meets with this punch, which is the accessory, that we have a crime. So this alone cannot constitute a crime. This, in most cases, cannot constitute a crime. So it was in this and this matching up together, which is that we use the menstrual for us to have a crime. Classification of offenses. Offenses are classified into two. We have felonies, which is a crime, whether that's more serious than a misdemeanor. We have misdemeanor, we have simple offenses. Misdemeanor, sorry. Now, simple offenses are just felonies. Misdemeanor are bad, very, very bad. They're felonies and dangerous. So, these are classes of offenses. Felonies are crimes, whether that's more serious than misdemeanor. So, what makes a felony or misdemeanor, there's a kind of punishment method for each of them. Now, the classification can be by nature of punishment attached to a particular offense. A person can only be punished for his fault and not the fault of others. So if, for instance, my wife is guilty of an offense, I cannot be held liable for her. She's guilty as an individual, and the liability cannot transfer to me unless it is found on an accomplice to the act. Otherwise, she'll be answerable only for herself. So that's the components of the Nigerian criminal judicial system. We have the states, we have the police, this is the police logo. We have the elephants and the eagle. We have the court system, this is the courts in Nigeria. We have the attorneys, these are the lawyers in Nigeria. So the Supreme Court, we have the prison services. So we have these major actors in the legal system, the states, the police, the court system, the armies, the prison services. These are the major actors in Nigeria criminal legal system. Conclusion, the Nigerian criminal justice system is ever evolving and cannot be fully comprehended on the pictures of this slide. So to understand more about our criminal justice and legal system in general, it should be a pleasure to welcome you to Nigeria. So this is Nigeria, very beautiful country, made up of great places, very green, you know, good aerial view, waterways, beautiful city, everybody wants to come to Nigeria. So I hope that one day all of you will come to Nigeria. Come to Nigeria. Will you come to Nigeria? Maybe, okay. Alright, so thank you all very much. So this was Lava, thank you.
Okay, thank you so much. Is there any questions about Nigerian criminal law, criminal justice? Please.
Abuja.
Okay. Any questions? Okay, I have one question for you. How many clients in your criminal code? How many clients do you know?
How many?
Clients together, total crime.
Okay, crime that they in my criminal code.
Yeah.
Wow, on top of that, I'll find out. I'll research, I'll find out.
So, how many provisions?
Provisions?
Yeah.
I'll still confirm that. But like I said, the crime, our crimes are in three categories. We have the offenses, the simple offenses, the misdemeanor, and the felonies.
Yeah. Thank you so much. And okay, Nigeria is very beautiful. I hope in the future I can visit there. Thank you so much.
Yes,
thank
also
you.
Many Chinese people in Nigeria.
Yeah, I know. Okay, thank you so much.
All right, thank you.